Good morning, Spurs fans. Excuse me, it's Saturday morning, it's game day. Always love a nice early start on a Saturday when we're playing. And it's Everton today and 5:30 kickoff, which we've done pretty well at so far this season. We beat Leicester 6-2 on a 5:30 kickoff. We beat Brighton on a 5:30 kickoff. There might have been more, but that two spring to mind. And now we've got Everton today and hopefully we'll do the same. As I've been saying since the very start of the season, we have to turn Tottenham Hotspur Stadium into a fortress. And if you look at the stats, we've pretty much done that. Since April the 16th, in the middle of last season, when we lost to Brighton, a game I had the misfortune to be at, we have played 12 matches at home in all competitions, and we've won 11 of them. That is the way it's got to be. I want to be here in 10 matches time saying we played 22 matches and won 21 of them. You know, it really is important that we get maximum points every game we play at home, because some of the away games can be tricky, as we've seen so far this season, especially Arsenal. And with Man United coming up during the week, which is going to be a tricky game because they always seem to turn up against us, except maybe 4 years ago when we beat them 6-1, which is quite an achievement. We've got an injury problem today, I think. We don't have Kulusevski, definitely, and it's looking like Rikarlison may have picked up a knock against Eintracht Frankfurt on Wednesday night. He may not be fit. So where does that leave us? Do we play 3-5-2, which I don't want to play at home, or do we bring in Lucas Moura, or exceptionally bring in Brian Hill, reward him for his efforts in his 15-minute cameo against Eintracht? Hard to know. We'll know at 4:30 anyway what the story is, but it does look like Rikarlison may not be fit to play against his old team, which is a pity. Because I would love to see him score against them, get his first league goal against his old team. And with that in mind, we have got to remember this is the first league match we've played at home since the Marine died. So I'm sure they'll have some sort of a tribute to him in the programme and whatever. Just saw something in the paper this morning I thought was fascinating. Do you remember, obviously English fans will remember this, the hand of God, Maradona, the goal he scored in the 1986 World Cup against England with his hand. Well, apparently the referee at that match took hold of the ball after the game and took it home with him. And now it's been auctioned off and it's expected to fetch 2.8 million. I'll tell you, that's some referee was cute enough. He must have seen the possibilities of making money out of that. And also the shirt Maradona wore in that game sold earlier this year for 8.5 million. So that got me to think, to keep it Tottenham related, it got me to think, do you remember Maradona played at White Hart Lane in Ozzy Ardiles' testimonial back in the 80s? If somebody has that shirt or they know where that shirt is, they could be sitting in quite a few bob, because I'm sure that would fetch a lot of money at auction if it was still available. So that's about it, I think. Short and sweet again today. It'll be better tomorrow or this evening whenever we know what the result of the game is. Hopefully it's going to be a big win. We beat them 5-0 last March when they were in a bit of disarray then. And like today, I suppose the only regret I have is Andros Townsend won't get a chance to get a bit of a reception from the Spurs fan. It's always nice when an ex-player comes back to play for another team. Unless, of course, he scores a goal, then it's a disaster that he's back. And Andros will be missing tonight. And here's to get the crowd behind the team tonight. Really, really get behind them, push on. Because our performances have been improving steadily. And as I've been saying for the last number of weeks, someday, sometime, some team is going to leave White Hart Lane with their tail between their legs. Leicester have already done it score-wise, but not performance-wise, maybe. So what we need to do tonight is put a load of goals past Everton and to give us the confidence to have two tough matches next week, Man United away and Newcastle at home next weekend. And then we've got the little matter of getting revenge on Sporting Lisbon after that. So keep behind the team. They're on a roll now, so let's keep it there and come on, you Spurs.